A dry erase board is a non-permanent surface most commonly used in professional or classroom environments. You simply write on the board with a dry erase marker and use a specialized cloth to wipe away the markings. These effective tools are an easy way to get your message across. Dry erase boards are also known as whiteboards. The boards wipe perfectly clean due to its non-porous surface and the dry erase ink. Dry erase ink contains release agents, which prevent the pigments from permanently adhering to the surface. Green and black dry erase boards can also be used as chalkboards, while gray and low-gloss white double as projection boards. The surface material is a porcelain-coated steel sheet, flexible enough to be rolled up, but also pressure-sensitive. To start, the roll is mounted on a cutting machine. A technician programs the machine to cut the roll to a specific length based on the board's dimensions. Workers verify the length and check that the piece is square. The surface material will be applied to one of seven types of substrate, ranging from cardboard to medium-density fiberboard known as MDF. The next step is to cut the large sheet of substrate, in this case MDF, into board-sized pieces. Another technician enters the length and width into the cutting machine. Once complete, the machine ejects the substrate, which is now cut to the exact size of the board. Next, the substrate is put through a hot glue machine. The machine applies polyurethane adhesive to what will be the back of the dry erase board. As the substrate exits, a sheet of foil is applied to the glued surface. The foil prevents moisture from entering, which would warp the substrate. The board moves through two steel rollers, which flatten the foil and press out any trapped air. Next, the surface material is applied to the other side of the substrate. A craftswoman uses an air hose to clear away any dust from the side of the board. Once cleaned, the board goes through the glue machine. The porcelain steel sheet is placed on the glued surface. Technicians work carefully to ensure they don't touch the pressure-sensitive surface with their fingers. Then the board moves through the steel rollers to press the porcelain steel flat and remove any trapped air. Once 50 boards are stacked, technicians put them in a press for half an hour until the glue cures. In another part of the factory, a machine cuts material to create the board's frame. It punches V-shaped notches in the length of aluminum trim. The trim bends at each notch to form a wraparound frame. Some boards come with a marker tray that runs along the bottom. To make these trays, a technician cuts board-length pieces from a piece of L-shaped metal trim. Since the tray ends are sharp, a technician attaches plastic covers for protection. He secures the plastic end covers with screws on both ends of the part. Meanwhile, technicians peel off the protective film covering the writing surface. Then they flip over the board to assemble the parts from the back. This model doesn't have the traditional wraparound frame. Instead, it has a frame comprised of four straight C-shaped pieces that fit over the board's edges. To add stability, technicians attach screws through the trim into the substrate. Once assembly is complete, The dry erase board is placed into a box, ready to be shipped to a business or classroom near you.